Shavua Tov, a gute Woche, and welcome to our program. This is the broadcast of Mitzvah Shabbos Kedesh before Hanukkah. Tomorrow, Mirtzeh Hashem, tomorrow night, we are lighting the first candle of Hanukkah. We find the original source for the Yom Tov of Hanukkah. Let's open up the Gemara. It's in Shabbos, Daf Chof Aleph, the famous Gemara, where the Rambam says, first of all, the question is, my Chanukah. What is Chanukah? And as Rashi says, Al Eze Nes Kov Uho. On what Nes did we establish Chanukah? Because there was more than one Nes. There's the Nes of the Pach HaShemen, and there's the Nes of the Melchomeh. So the Gemara starts, the Tone Rabbonon, we have the Rabbonon have learned that Kishenichnesu, then the Gemara says, Shekshenichnesu Yevonim Lehechol, that when the Yevonim, the Greeks, came into the Hechol, Timul Kol Ashmanim Shebehechol, they have contaminated all the Shmanim, all the oils that was in the Hechol. Uchshegovro Malchus Beis Chashmenoi V'nitzchum, and when the kingdom of the Chashmenoim was successful, when the Hashmonites were successful, v'nitzchum, and they were victorious over the Greeks, botku v'limotzu elapach echot shel shemen, they have checked, and they couldn't find only one jar of oil, shehoyomunoch b'chisome shel kein godil. And that jar of oil, we all know the story, was hidden with the seal of the Kain Godil. There was only enough for one night. There was a nes and they were able to do it 8 days, and it's the 8 days of Hanukkah. We all know the story. When we look at this Gemara, Kishenichnesu Yevonim Lehechol, when the Yevonim went into the Hechol, Timu Kol Ashmanim Shebehechol, they have contaminated all the shmanim, all the oil. One will ask a very, very obvious question. That's not what a terrorist does. Kshenichnusu Yevonim Lehechol. They came in, the terrorist comes into the Beis HaMikdash, and he sees a jar of oil. What does a terrorist do with a jar of oil? Simply, he breaks the jar and he spills the oil. Timu kol ashmanim shebehechol, that when the Yevonim came into the Hechol, the first thing they did is they contaminated all the oil. This is not what an enemy does, and this is not what a terrorist does. So how do you reconcile that with the story that happened? We will return to that in a moment, but first, our customary story. This is the story with the Rebbe. And it happened on Chof Dalet Kislev, the first night of Hanukkah, Tovshin Nun Beis. And as we know, Tovshin Nun Beis is a very sensitive year. The last time, Imiyat Hashem soon to start again, that the Rebbe spoke to us on Hanukkah. And it was the end of 1991. And there was a satellite. And the Rebbe spoke about what the satellite does and that it unites people from all over the world. That a Jew who is found in one place of the world can find out what another Jew that's on the other side of the world does. And it can bring unity. And then the Rebbe says, as we see, that we are speaking here, and they are Jews who are in Eretz Yisrael, and in Moscow, and then the Rebbe said, and in Calcutta. In Calcutta, Calcutta was not part of the satellite. And the Rebbe specifically mentions Calcutta. How do you understand that? Well, at that time, nobody did. 10 years later, the year is 2001. And two Bochrim make their way from Mumbai to Calcutta to help strengthen Yiddishkeit. And they meet there with the president of the Jewish community. And he says to them, I want to tell you a story about the Rebbe. He says, 10 years ago, I was in Calcutta. It was Hanukkah. And I am sad and I am lonely. And I say to myself, do I have to light the menorah? And what will I do? One Jew on my own, I will light the menorah, I'll give a little light. What's the big thing? And then I sit down on the couch and I go through, flip through the channels. And then I see on one of the channels, I see the Rebbe's picture. So I stopped and I listened to what the Rebbe said. And what did the Rebbe say? The Rebbe said that through the satellite, all Jews are united, and there can be a Jew in Brooklyn, and he knows, or another person who is on the other side of the world, in Moscow or in Calcutta. And then I said to myself, the Rebbe is talking to me. And I quickly lighted the Hanukkah menorah. Rabbi say, concerning our question, Kishenichnesu Yevonim Lehechol, Timu Kol Hashmanim Shebehechol, they have contaminated all the shmanim, all the oils. Lechere, that's not what a terrorist does. In way of answering that, the Rebbe says that we have to understand another question. And with that question, we will understand that this the first question as well. What is the obligation on Hanukkah? Is there an obligation to have a Hanukkah feast? Well, everyone is going to answer, what do you mean an obligation to have a Hanukkah feast? I'm going to my grandmother and to my grandfather and to my uncle and to my aunt for Hanukkah parties all the time. Wonderful. Is that obligatory or is that optional? What's the question? And the answer is, on Hanukkah, it's not obligatory. It's optional. As a matter of fact, one of the Mefarshim says, and all the mesibes that we make on Hanukkah, with the latkes and everything, wonderful, wonderful festivities, well, it's not obligatory. On Purim, it's obligatory. On Hanukkah, it's optional. As a matter of fact, the Rambam paskens, and let's open the Rambam inside, what is the obligation that we have on Hanukkah? So let's see what the Rambam says inside. It's in Hilchas Megillah of Chanukah. The Rambam in the third Perek. The Rambam writes that we have, in it's Perek Gimel of Hilchas Megillah of Chanukah. And the Rambam writes that we have an obligation of Yemei Simcha VeHalil. These are the days of happiness and Halil and giving thanks to Almighty God. Now, and the way it's explained, Simcha for the Nes and Halil for the Menorah. But it says Halil, it does not say that we have to make a special feast like on Purim. The feast on Purim is obligatory. As a matter of fact, for us to think, the halachas in the Rambam concerning Chanukah are under the rubric of Hilchas Megillah v'Chanukah. Together, Megillah and Hanukkah. So first of all, the question is, why Megillah and Hanukkah? Why not Hanukkah and Megillah? Because the Rambam goes in accordance to the Seder of the year. And in the Seder of the year, Hanukkah comes before Purim. That's how it is every year. You know, there is like this individual who once started and was a Yutis Kislev, and he says, this year Yutis Kislev is before Hanukkah. And he happened to be right. That year, Yutis Kislev was before Hanukkah. And every year, Yutis Kislev is before Hanukkah. By the same token, Hanukkah this year is before Purim. That's how it is. And that's how it was last year and the year before, and that's how it is. So therefore, arguably, Hanukkah should have come before. So the Magid Mishnah asks this question, and he says that the reason that the Rambam first writes the halachas of Megillah and then Chanukah, lefishe kodma bizman or lefishe hi bikisvei hakedush, because in time it happened, the story of Purim happened before the story of Chanukah, and also the story of Purim is mentioned in scripture in Kisvei HaKedush. Wonderful. So this is why Megillah has to come before Chanukah. What he doesn't answer, Lechela, and it leaves us for us to think that if that's the case, it should have been arguably Hilchas Megillah separate and then Hilchas Chanukah. He says that Megillah, that the story of Purim came before Chanukah. Wonderful. He says that Megillah is mentioned in Scripture and Megillah says to, agreed. So therefore, it should be one halacha for Megillah. And the setting halacha for Chanukah, two separate halachas. As a matter of fact, in Hilchas Megillah v'Chanukah, there are four perakim. Aleph and Beis is for Megillah, Gimel and Dalet is for Chanukah. Lechela, it should have been arguably Hilchas Megillah separate, and then Hilchas Chanukah, the halachas of Purim separate, halachas of Chanukah separate. Now, what is interesting, that in the Rambam, they're probably different prints. The Rambam that we have, that in the beginning it says Hilchas Megillah v'Chanukah. Wonderful. And later it says, Zmanim, Hilchas Megillah Perik Aleph. Then Hilchas Megillah Perik Aleph, Hilchas Megillah Perik Beis. It doesn't say on top Megillah v'Chanukah, it says only Megillah. And then when you come to Chanukah Perik Gimel, starts Chanukah, it says Hilchas Chanukah Perik Gimel, Hilchas Chanukah Perik Dalet. So therefore, even in the way it's printed, it starts with Megillah v'Chanukah. I don't know who made that change. Lechela, that the rubric comes from the Rambam, Hilchas Megillah v'Chanukah. Later, maybe it comes from the printer, but that is something for us to look into and to think about. Now, what we see here is that there's only an obligation on Chanukah. The obligation is only in the language of the Rambam, only Yimei Simcha VeHalil, but we're not talking about a feast. On Purim, the feast is obligatory. And the answer to that is, and this will answer the first question, Kshenichnasu Yevonim LeHeichol, Timu Kol Hashmanim SheBeHeichol, that Purim, the decree was against the body of the Jew, against the physical existence of the Jew. Therefore, the celebration is also in a physical way. Asuda and everything, libsume bepudia and wine and so on. On Chanukah, from the start, the gzeira was not on the physical part of the Jews, only on the spiritual part. This is why also the answer to that is only spiritual, Simcha v'Halil. And where do you see it? You see it from the Gemara. Kishenichnasu Yevonim Leheichol. What did they do? These were not terrorists the way we know. They were not out to destruct the physical part of the Jewish community. They were out to destruct the spiritual part of the Jewish community. So the first thing they did, and from the Loshen, Kishenichnasu Yevonim Leheichol, which means the moment they went in, what's the first thing they did? They did Timu Kol Hashmanim SheBeHeichol. They didn't break the jars. They didn't break the jars. They made sure not to break the jars because they wanted the Jewish people to use those jars. So they contaminated the jars. So they wanted that we should use those jars in the Beis HaMikdash and light the menorah in the Beis HaMikdash with contaminated oil. So therefore, we are bringing in a contaminated light, the light of the Yevonim, into the Beis HaMikdash. So they wanted to contaminate us spiritually. And this is what we see from the Gemara. And this is why the response to that is also a spiritual one. Hallel v'heido. And this is why the Rebbe stresses. They said, Lehashkichom teirosecho. They wanted to make the people forget that it's your teir. They didn't care that you are learning Torah. As a matter of fact, they consider themselves a very intelligent nation, and they like the give and take of the Talmud, the sharpness of the Talmud. They like that. It sharpens the mind. They like that. However, what they didn't want is the Nesina Torah, Leashkicham Torah Secho, that it's your Torah, the spiritual part of the Torah. This is what disturbed them. And because of that, our response is also the spiritual part of Hanukkah, and we light the menorah, and as the Rebbe wants, we light the menorah on the outside, and we illuminate the entire world to make sure that we are proud of what Almighty gave us. And we are doubly proud, and so on, that each and every single person knows how he should express his pride and her pride in the fact that we are the nation that Almighty God chose for Torah mitzvahs. Rabbi Isai, I wanted to draw your attention to another thing. And it's now, before Yuchvat, 70 years of the Nesiyas of the Rebbe. It is interesting that in a Sicha, Purim Tovshin Lamed Beis, Purim Tovshin Lamed Beis, the Rebbe spoke, and the Rebbe says that there are going to be people who will want to give him a gift for his birthday, Yud Aleph Nissen, and therefore the Rebbe wants that the gift should be connected with something in Torah. And although the Rebbe said that when you cannot really, when you get a gift, you can't say, I would like this gift, I would like that gift. You generally do not specify what kind of gift you want. But the Rebbe explained, since you are giving a gift, because you want through the gift that there should be a happiness, there should be a satisfaction. So the Rebbe says that this is how you're going to cause a satisfaction through learning. Now, one would ask a question. The Rebbe spoke about it, Purim Tovshin Lamed Beis. It's before Yud Aleph Nissen. But why Tovshin Lamed Beis? It could have been Tovshin Lamed Aleph. It's also before Yud Aleph Nissen. And Tovshin Lamed is also before Yud Aleph Nissen. All the years. As a matter of fact, Purim always comes before Yud Aleph Nissen. Why Tovshin Lamed Beis? So first of all, we cannot know the Rebbe's Kavonah. Nevertheless, the Rebbe wants that we should try to understand on our own. Tovshin Lamed Beis was Shnas HaShivim. The Rebbe became 70 years old. So this is the preparation for Shnas HaShivim. And this is why the Rebbe said it that year. He didn't say it before, he didn't say it after. This is the preparation of Shnas HaShivim, that if he wants the preparation for Shnas HaShivim to be connected with Torah. Rebbe say, we are now preparing for Shnas HaShivim, for 70 years of the Rebbe's Nesiyas. And this is why, according to the Rebbe himself, the biggest gift you can give him, and as you know, our Rebbe doesn't need our gifts. However, here he specified that this is a gift that he likes, a gift of Torah. And therefore, there's a special effort made of learning the Rebbe's Torah. Baruch Hashem, there are 250 volumes of the Torah of the Rebbe. And we have made a special site. And the name of the site is yudshvat70.com. 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 We put on this website all of the 250 volumes, or close to that, of the Rebbe's Torah. Baruch Hashem, as we are talking today, 40% of that was taken already. But we hope that it'll be 100%, and there'll be Chalukah Aleph and Chalukah Beis, and so on. However, if you go on the website today, yudshvat70.com, yudshvat70.com. You'll be able to participate. And not only that, Rabbi Isai, not only are you going to participate together with everyone, and it's going to be a question of, it's going to be a matter of achdus with everyone. It's going to be a matter of teira together with everyone. But more than everything, it's going to be a gift, a matana to the Rebbe. I remember an individual who told me that he went into Yechidus. It was before Yud Aleph Nissen. And the Rebbe said to one of the children, "What kind of matana are you preparing for me for Yud Aleph Nissen?" So, in that way, as a father would ask his child, "What kind of matana are you preparing?" Although it's not nice to ask for a matana. Nobody wants a matana, and the Rebbe doesn't need our matanas. There's nothing that the Rebbe needs that we can do. However, this the Rebbe wants. If we do teira and everything that comes with it, but he specifically asks for teira. So if you join the website, you will be able to take whatever you want, and then it's going to be, not only is it going to be a question of achdus, and not only is it going to be a question, Emil Tashem, satisfactory answer to teira, it will be a collective matone to our Rebbe for 70 years of the Nesiyas of the Rebbe. The Rebbe said on Yud Aleph, on Yud Shvat Tovshin Yud Aleph, that was the formal day of the Rebbe's Nesiyas, as to what he is going to accomplish with his Nesiyas. And he mentioned that in America, Rebbe mentioned there's a Maimed Chazal, Azir Lekalto Avid Kenimuso. When you come to a town, you do as the customs of the town. In America, there is a custom when there is a new president, he makes a declaration, a statement as to what his administration is going to achieve. And in that vein, the Rebbe said what he is going to achieve, bringing Mashiach Tzidkenu Bepeil Mamash. And learning Teira, together with Achdus, together with Teira, that is the key of bringing Mashiach Bepeil Mamash, and we can do it together through Achdus and through Teira, Besimcha Uvtuv Leivov, and cause our Rebbe a great, great amount of real satisfaction, doing something that the Rebbe really likes. And through this, Emir Tashem, as the Rebbe says, we will see the coming of Mashiach Tzidkenu that the Rebbe will bring Bepeil Mamesh, Ubagolo Didan, Uvesimcho Uvtuv Leivov, Uveteva Nire Vehanilo, Lemato Measorot Fochim, Uvechesed, Uverachamim, Vetekef, Umiyad, Mamesh.